Hello, welcome. Today we're going to be looking at relationship between three sets. Between how many sets?
Three sets.
Three sets. And we say that every set, using the Venn diagram representation, is normally represented using a what? And the universal set is presented using a what? Rectangle. So this is three sets. Can you see the set once? The first set is known as set what? And the second set is set what? And the third set is set what? Can you see where the three of them, did the three of them join here? Did the three of them join here?
No.
Here is only which ones are joining? A and what? B. Here, which ones are joining? R and what? B. Here, which ones are joining? R and K. But inside here, how many are joining? Three of them. So this point where all of them are joining that is shaded is known as what? R intersection K intersection what? B. Can you look at this set? Which of the sets are joining in the shaded portion here?
K and B.
K and B, is it not? So the shaded portion is where K and P has the same element. And it is represented as K intersection what? P. Can you see K and P, they are intersecting? Now intersection of what? Non-R. Non-R, is that clear? Because everything here is not inside R. Can you see that? Because this is R. Everything here is not inside R. So that's why we are using R prime. Is that clear? Now what are we having here? We are having things that are only in P, but are not in Q and things that are only in R but are not in K and P, is that clear?
Yeah.
So we call it R intersection, not K. You understand? K prime simply means not K. So if it is not K, it has to be around R, is it not? Intersection, not P or P prime, which is here only, is that clear? Now, if we have all the three of them shaded, we have R, we have K, and we have P. Oh, shaded, we call it what? What do we call this?
Union.
R what? Union what? K union what? P. Is that clear? What if we have all of them separated? We have what to call what?
Disjoint.
We have what to call what?
Disjoint.
Is that clear? So this is how you represent sets, very importantly. Now, before we move on to the example, we are going to represent two sets using the two sets and the three sets, and you're going to tell me where and how to label each. Are we looking?
Yes.
Anu, are you looking?
Yes.
This is the first one. Is that clear? And this is the what? Second one. Here we have sets and we have this. We have P and Q. And here we have three sets, and we have R, O, M. Is that clear? Now tell me where I can represent P union Q. Okay, let's start with intersection. Where is P intersection Q?
Where do you join?
Where is it? Inside here, is it not?
Yes.
So inside here, we can represent what? P intersection what? Is that?
Yes.
Where can we represent only K?
K.
Only K will be here, right?
Yes.
Is that?
Yes.
Is that?
Yes.
Where will we represent only P?
Only
here, right?
Yes.
Very, very important. Where do we represent the M intersection? This should be capital letter, huh?
Yes.
M intersection R intersection O. Where should that be here?
Middle,
isn't it? Where can we have M intersection O intersection R prime?
Yes. Down far.
Where?
Yes.
Is it here?
Yes.
Thank you. That is here. Is that clear?
Yes.
Where can we have R intersection M intersection O prime?
The top. No, by your left.
Here,
yes.
Is that clear?
Yes.
So very importantly, you need to know where to find each one. You understand? Because we are going to be using this to solve real problems in Venn diagram. Is that clear? Please, if you like this our video, click on the subscribe button, like and share this our video. Thanks for your subscriptions and support.